Hi there, my name is Ian Bonhote, Bonhote actually, if I say it properly. I'm the director from Alleycats. I came up with the concept of Alleycats and then I worked on it with different writers to get it here. And I actually executive produced Alleycats as well. The film overall started more from the visual side. So I shot a music video in 2007, which actually portrayed Alleycats because I was very much into that culture when I was younger. And I just saw the potential of visually creating some thrilling, exciting, never seen before visual. And I thought that developing an action thriller fitted very well that world and that culture. So we basically develop a story, but mostly inspired by the couriers themselves and the Alleycat racing. So from that point, we took a long, long time to develop and to get the script right, which we managed to do. We took a bit of a break because in 2012, another film came out called Premium Rush, and we just thought, oh, maybe it's a bit too similar. And it ended up not being similar at all of what we wanted to portray. So a year after the film came out, we started to pull the script again and start working on it again. The lead character is called Danny, and she's played by Eleanor Tomlinson. And she's basically, she's the sister of the other another character called Chris, which is played by Josh Whitehouse. And she comes back to London after a year or two abroad, we don't say exactly, but she kind of left the community, kind of escaped, needed to get out of there. And she comes back and something happened to her brother and she needs to be involved within the community and sort of fight a way through the truth, in a way. Rose Wickstead, which did the casting, which is the casting director, we saw huge amount of actresses. Huge, I think we casted around 70 or 80 actresses and loads of really talented actresses, which, you know, could be great for different roles, but Eleanor was, yeah, she really nailed it. And I think what was interesting for me is that it's not that that the public knew about Eleanor. It's not a side of Eleanor that she had portrayed before in another film. So it was very exciting to work with her on creating a complete different character for her. You know, she's, you know, you can't be further away from Paul Dark and Demzela in Paul Dark. So, yeah.
Wow, I think for me it was just something really different, something that I'd never done before. I've done a lot of period drama, so it's really nice to kind of branch out of that and try something really challenging. I couldn't ride a bike beforehand, so I had to learn to do that. Again, another challenge. So, yeah, it was great. A very exciting new thing for me to be a part of. The thing with Danny is that she's been off travelling and she's had a break from this courier lifestyle, and she comes back to her roots because she misses her family and her friends, and she's very close to her brother, and then all this kind of, you know, not mystery, but drama starts happening. So yeah, I mean, she's a complicated girl. There's a lot of issues there behind the scenes, but she's a good person at heart. Well, Ian, the director, was really helpful. He brought a bike over to my house and actually taught me through it, because with it being fixed gears, you know, the pedals keep moving without, you know, so you can't actually stop. So it's terrifying and very hard work, but good, really good fun and a great challenge. So yeah, just a lot of kind of cycling up and down the cycle tracks near my house and yeah, trying to get fit for it. We're in amongst real traffic. It was very scary. It was very, very scary to be amongst that and to see that, you know, the lifestyle that they live. But at the same time, that was kind of what was really exciting about it and what I loved. It was very real. Oh, I think it's incredibly important. And I think, you know, it's fantastic that, you know, we've got, you know, a foreign film director who's been able to come over here and make this movie. And, you know, I'm really pushing to kind of remain in the EU at the minute. So, you know, I think these events are incredibly important for you know, small films that are starting out as a way of people getting put on the map. And I'm all for supporting that. I think often the really interesting projects are the smaller ones. The next series is going to keep audiences very much on the edge of their seat. I think the relationships that you thought were so solid in the first series are going to get, you know, shaken up a bit. So that's going to be really interesting. I'm intrigued to see exactly how the audience respond to it. It's very exciting.
How you doing, guys? My name's Sam Keeley.
Sam, it's great to have you here tonight. What does it mean for you to be opening the East End Film Festival?
Yeah, it's a big deal. I think it's a great opportunity for films like ours, like independent films who are doing a genre you haven't seen before, to premiere at a festival that has, you know, kind of is prestigious in that world, you know, so it's an honour, yeah, it's great. The world of Alleycats is one I don't think we've seen before. It's based in the bicycle courier world of London, which to me I was completely ignorant to until I'd read the script, and I didn't know the depth of which these people's world goes, and these races and these lives they live. They're daredevils. They're modern day daredevils. So it's, you know, it's a really interesting thing that I think the world will get to see now that we haven't seen before. So it's good. My character's name is Jake, and he is a young man who has a kind of a relationship with another girl who's a courier in the group, and he's kind of like this kind of lovable kind of guy who wants to do right by his mates and stuff like that, but he's got a dark streak to him that kind of prompts him to go to places and do things that he may not necessarily have wanted to do, but he's a man of action, I think. A man of action.
My final question, what was it like working with the beautiful and very talented Eleanor?
Yeah, it was lovely. It was a dream working with Eleanor. Me and her just hit it off straight away. She's a lovely person, very, very talented and very hardworking, and she deserves all the credit she's getting at the moment. She's fantastic.
Hello, my name's Josh Whitehouse. I play Chris in Alleycats, the feature film. I mean, Chris is a very integral part to the story. You know, he's highly bonded with all of his good friends and his sister, and he's heavily involved in the group, but I would be cautious to tell you too much about Chris's part in the story because I wouldn't want to spoil it for you. The cast were just amazing. Eleanor and Sam did a fantastic job of really telling the whole story, you know, with the sort of two main parts there. But everyone was just brilliant to work with. Yeah, really everybody. And Ian's done a fantastic job. And I mean, like, you know, to be able to get a film, you know, that's a little more independent, a little smaller budget out of Britain again is a really fantastic achievement. So just well done to everybody, really. The reason I really wanted to be a part of Alleycats is I think it's a really strong part of London and culture, and you know, to show people the life of couriers, and I mean, it's a fictional story as well, but obviously just, you know, something that's so strong in our community and everything, I think it's a really great thing to be able to show to the world and have a part in. Independent cinema, you know, usually when a director or a writer and director or whatever has a project, usually you find in independent cinema a lot of passion projects and things that people have been trying their whole lives to make. And then, you know, once they've done that thing and they've been successful with their passion project, generally that is what leads on to the bigger films in the world, because somebody with a bigger budget goes, hey, you've done a fantastic job. Here's, you know, this amount to make this or do this and go on to further things. And I think, you know, every great director has to start out with their passion project. Events like this are hugely important to independent cinema, because you know, there's just films like this need exposure and they need support from everywhere they can get it, really, because it's a dog eat dog world. It's hard to get your creative project out to the public, so things like this are hugely important, really. At the moment, I've got a couple more indie films in the line. There's a fantastic story called Hello Joe about a young man that. He's autistic, and when he gets an anxiety attack, he becomes a car. And that's at the moment, that's sort of in the works. We're, you know, we've made a trailer and we're trying to raise the funds to turn it into a full-length feature. And there's a couple more projects bubbling away, but nothing's quite confirmed at this point, so I'm just sort of, I'm taking it easy right now and seeing what's yet to come. You should watch Alleycats when you get the chance, because it's informative on some of London's culture, but not only that, it's massively thrilling and exciting watch. The story and the drama is very compelling. And I mean, I don't want to give away too much, but I only saw so much of the film being made. And, you know, when I saw it for the first time, I was really sort of thrown back by just how much it slaps you in the face.
I'm very excited. And it's my first British film as well. So I'm very excited and I haven't seen it. And it's great to be here. The film is a thriller on bicycle. It's about couriers who do these illegal races in the streets of London, and then they end up seeing something they shouldn't see, and so people have me come in, and I'm a very bad guy. I'm a very bad guy from France.
What was it that appealed to you about playing such a very bad guy?
I love playing very bad guys. There's nothing like it. This one was very cool. It was very cold and focused. And fun to play. The team behind the camera, it was very interesting. It was very fast. We didn't have a lot of time to shoot, so you have to make decisions straight away. And there's a lot of pressure, but it's good pressure. You know, you won't be able to do it 5 or 6 times in a row, so you have to nail it straight from the part. And you know, I had total faith in Ian. He's a fantastic director, so it all went great. There's one point where I go really, really fast with a big Range Rover into a cyclist. And usually I had a dummy and I had to run straight into the dummy. Usually when you drive, you're not used to just aiming for something and going the fastest you can to it. That was great. I've just finished a series for Canal Plus that we shot in Denmark, where I'm a bad guy again. I'm a hitman that ends up doing so much trouble in London, I have to move to Copenhagen to hide, but then I end up killing more people in Copenhagen. That's going to air in September.
Hi, my name's Camilla Rutherford. Oh, so pleased to be here. I think it's always brilliant when a film opens a festival. And the East End Film Festival is a particularly diverse and cool festival. And I am a Londoner, however, a West Londoner, but it's good to cross that border sometimes. Well, Ian, the director, asked me to be in it, so I was absolutely delighted. I was, however, pregnant at the time, and he very sweetly wrote that into the script. It did work, well, I hope. I haven't seen the film yet. Well, she's the wife of the lead, and he's a very, not a very nice, well, that's my perspective anyway, not a very nice politician. I think I show another side to his character, which is his home life. And I don't like him very much. It makes me feel angry thinking about it, actually.
What was your experience like with the cast? Obviously, you didn't like the character, but what was it like working with the rest of the team on this one?
Oh, really good. Everyone was so kind. It was funny, though. Some people thought that my belly was prosthetic. It was actually real, but I've since got rid of it now and had my final child. As an actress, you're certainly not doing it for the money, which means that you generally really do like the project. And you don't always have to play in such a formulaic way. And you can be more strange and different in your interpretation, freer somehow.
How important do you think festivals like this are to the future of independent cinema?
Oh, so important. They give films a forum, a place to show them and give them a boost, which they need so much without the huge vehicle that the great big films have.
Hello, my name is Juan Cely. I am an actor, Latin American actor, and happy to stay here in Alleycats film. Pedro is a Mexican guy who organized all the Alleycats, the dangerous and fat and furious racing, and is really party guy and happy and Latin American. That's my role in the film. It's get a little bit the happy and drunk and party and dangerous Alleycats race in the film. Yeah, it's really, really fun. I always get fun because that's my passion. That's how I would love to do. And every single moment in this film, also working with all my partners in the movie, like Ian, the director, all the crew, it's really, really fun. I really enjoying it. Yeah. Great opportunity. I feel really excited about it because we need to stay with the independent films, with the people who love and got passion for do films, even an actor, producers, camera, all the crew, and stay in this East Festival and a film, filming in the East. So, it's a great experience, and hopefully this film. So gonna be great, and people love it. I promise I gonna love this film because we loved it every second we was in there.
Hi, my name's Fred Schmidt. I play Sid in the film. So they're a super tight knit group, and Sid is the anarchic one of the bunch, so to speak. But for me, it was really important because we work so closely with the guys who really do it for a living. And you get a real sense of a wildness that exists amongst them. I mean, they're all lovely guys. But so for me, it was important to have an element of that carefree, wild, just letting loose. I try to give a bit of that in Sid. So. And for me, it was just popping a lid on this crazy subculture. You see these guys running around all day in London. I've grown up in London, so, you know, back and forth. But actually, when you get into what they do in their spare time to go and do this, but the kind of extreme version of it, you know, and all the hijinks that kind of surrounds it, for me, that was fascinating, I'll be honest. I spent many hours on YouTube watching. What I didn't appreciate is that they have it in every single city. So any major city, New York, LA, Paris, they have all these crazy races going on all the time. So,
what was it like, particularly working with a beautiful talent like Eleanor?
She was great. You know, had to make sure that she was stayed on balance a few times on the bike. But no, she was great. You know, she was always up for doing stuff. And I think again, what was really important is because when we saw these real guys do it, there was such a close-knit community amongst themselves, and you know they would really look out for each other at every step. So I think for the cast, it was really important to kind of develop this real tight-knit community amongst ourselves. And the schedule was crazy to shoot and everything, so I think it just plunged us together much more tighter in a way, and it really made, I think by the end of it, I made, you know, 6 good friends who I can really, really, really happy to call my friends as well. So,
my name is Andee Ryder. I'm the producer of Alleycats. It's really exciting to be opening the East End Film Festival, particularly because we shot the film all in East London. So we're really pleased to basically screen the film like millimeters away from where we shot. It was very tough to film this film, particularly the action. Very difficult to film it in central London. To get the shots of the actors going through heavy traffic in central London is extremely difficult. So we had to be very clever with how we filmed it. We worked a lot with the police, the Metropolitan Police. We worked with bike couriers to use their footage. And we worked with camera crews to film stuff on the back of goods. So we just had to be very clever, creative, and very well planned in how we shot it. But it was very challenging, but in the end, I think it looks great. With Eleanor, with casting, obviously the character of Danny is a really strong female character, and we wanted someone who could play that lead. So we did our research, and we could see work that Eleanor's done before, that she was just brilliant for it. And then for her, it was quite a different role for her because she's done a lot of period roles before. So we hoped that she would be interested in doing something that's a bit different, which she was. And when we met her, and then, you know, she said she was up for it and on board, we just knew she'd bring a lot to the role, and she was absolutely amazing. Independent cinema obviously doesn't have to live up to the money ticking boxes exercise that studio cinema does. You have to just basically, you can make a film a little bit more brave, a little bit more ambitious, and a little bit more daring. We wouldn't have been able to do this film through the studio system the way we did it. It's just simple. You'd be just able to take a few more risks and try and do something a bit fresh and a bit different. We hope the audience take away from seeing the film tonight just basically, more than anything, enjoyment, excitement, seeing a film that maybe is showed them something they haven't seen before, which is the Alleycat racing, because actually these things are real, they really do happen, and most people don't know about them. And so our film maybe gives you a little insight into that world.